Hi everybody, welcome to Mathematics Online Class 1. Today we'll learn the basics of the mathematics which are very necessary for all the classes from the 6th to 10th. The basics. In the basics of the mathematics, we have the addition, subtraction, multiplication, divisions, and some notations of the mathematics that we call the vocabulary of the mathematics is also very important. Most of the students are knowing the logic of the mathematics, subject of the mathematics, and the concept of the mathematics, but at the time of the simplification they are doing wrong. They are only, due to the lack of the perfect knowledge of the simplifications, they are getting the fear of mathematics. For that sake, today we will learn first the basics of the mathematics. In the basics of the modern mathematics, first we will see the fundamental operations of mathematics. What are the fundamental operations of the mathematics? Plus, minus, multiplication, that is into, divided by, these are the four fundamental operations of the mathematics. And we have some notations or some other forms of the addition, minus, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Other forms is called by other names, like this. See, addition of numbers is called sum of numbers. That is, addition of 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. Instead of saying addition of 2 and 3, here we say sum of 2 and 3 is 5. Next we have subtraction. Subtraction of numbers is called difference of numbers. That is, 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. Subtraction of 8 and 5 is equal to 3. And that we read it as difference of 8 and 5 is 3. Next we have multiplication of numbers. We call it as product of numbers. Here we have 7 into 6 is equal to 42. That is, product of 7 and 6 is called 42. That is, multiplication we call it as a product. And next we have the division, we call it as a quotient. We take the example here, 15 divided by 3. When I divide 15 with 3, I will get the quotient 5. That is, the answer is 5. This we read as the quotient of 15 and 3 is 5. Like this, addition we call it as sum. Subtraction we call it as a difference, multiplication we call it as a product, and division we call it as a quotient. Okay, this we have to remember. Next, we will see the fundamental operations in set of numbers. First, we will take here integers. Before going to fundamental operations in integers, we will see what are integers. We know negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. This total combination set is called as integers. It is denoted by the English alphabet capital letter Z. That is, Z is equal to dash 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 dash, that is minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, dash 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 dash. That means it starts from the infinite and ends to the infinite. We do not have the smallest number from where it is starting, and do not have the largest number where it ends. Okay, it starts from infinite to infinity. Infinite here, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, dash, 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 so on, are negative numbers or negative integers. 1, 2, 3, 4, you are not defining the sign. If you are not defining the sign also, we call it, you can treat it as a positive only. Though that's why you call that 1, 2, 3, 4, dash, 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 or and so on are called as positive numbers or positive integers. Next we have zero. Zero, it is neither a negative number nor a positive number. What is the number which is neither negative nor positive number? Means it is nothing but zero. Next, addition of integers. Now in the fundamental operation, first operation is addition. We'll see the addition of the integers. In the addition of the integers, this is very important to all the class students, because the simplification works will done on this basic concept, fundamental operations in the integers. There only most of the students, even the above average students, are also doing same mistakes, that minus, plus, they are getting confusion. That's why you have to listen it very carefully. Now see the addition of integers. In the addition of integers, first we'll take the addition of two positive numbers or positive integers. Numbers and integers means that is a set of numbers, that only. Okay, addition of two positive numbers. Now here +5 + +3, addition of two positive numbers 5 and positive number 3. We are getting here 8, or simply called 5 + 3 = 8. That means by adding the two positive integers, first we have to add the numbers 5 and 3, then 5 + 3 is nothing but 8, then keep the sign of the positive, because both are the positive sign, you have to keep the positive sign. That is addition of two positive integers is a positive integer. Next we'll go to the addition of two negative numbers or integers. Here we'll take the two negative numbers and we'll add them, -5 + -3. -5 is a negative number, -3 is a negative number. I'm adding both the negative numbers. What I'm getting here, first when you are adding the two negative numbers, first you have to add the numbers first. Both are negative, means we add the numbers 5 + 3 = 8, and keep the sign what the both the number has. It is a negative sign, you have to keep the negative sign. That means when you are adding the two negative numbers or two positive numbers, we have to add the numbers and keep the sign whatever the two numbers contain. Okay, that is addition of two negative integers is a negative integer, addition of two positive integers is a positive integer, and addition of two negative integers is a negative integer. Next we will go to the addition of positive number and negative number. One number will take positive and other number will take a negative. Here 5 + -3, 5 + 5 is a positive, -3 is a negative. One positive and negative number I am adding here. Means first what you have to do here, if you have the two different signs, here +5 - -3 and -5 + 3, you have to subtract the numbers, that is 5 and 3. If you subtract 5 - 3, you get 2. Here also 5 - 3 2, but you have to decide the sign. That means first you subtract the numbers and what is the sign you have to keep here, that is very important here. Whatever the big greatest number sign it has, you have to keep that sign. That means here in the first section you see here 5 + -3, the biggest number is 5, it has a positive sign, you give the +2. In the second example you can see here the biggest number is 5, it has a minus sign, you have to give the -2. When you have the two different signs, you have to subtract the numbers and keep the sign of the greatest number. Next you will see the, that is addition of positive integer and negative integer. There is a chance of getting positive number or a negative number. Whereas in when you are adding the two positive numbers, you are getting a positive number. Whereas in when you are adding the two negative numbers, you are getting a negative number. But when you are adding the one positive and one negative number, there is a chance of getting the positive integer or a negative integer. It depends upon the greatest number's sign. Okay. Next, we'll go to the some examples. Sum of 20 and 50. Sum means we know addition. That is 20 plus 50 is equal to 70. And sum of minus 20 and minus 50 is. Here we are adding the two negative integers. Means first we have to add the numbers 20 plus 50. It is 70. And both have the negative numbers. You have to give the minus. That is minus 70. Sum of minus 20 and 50. Here we are adding one negative number and a positive number. When you are adding the negative number and a positive number, you have the two different sign numbers. That means you have to subtract the numbers. 50 minus 20 will get 30, and the biggest number has the plus sign. We have to keep the plus 30. Next, sum of 20 and minus 50. Here also we are adding the one positive and one negative number. Two different signs are there for the two different numbers. Therefore, you have to subtract the number 50 minus 20, it is 30, and the sign you have to keep for the sign of the biggest number. That is, biggest number is 50, it has a minus sign, you have to give the minus 30. Like this, we have to do, no need to confuse here. When you are adding two positive numbers, add the numbers and keep the sign positive. When adding the two negative numbers, add the numbers and keep the sign negative. If you are adding the one negative number and one positive number, or one positive number and negative number, we have to subtract the numbers and keep the sign of the biggest number. Okay, next we'll go to the subtraction of the integers. First operation, addition. Next we'll go to the subtraction of the integers. While subtracting any two integers, first subtraction has to change or convert to addition form, then we have to add the integers as usually we done in the addition of the integers in before. Now we have done it. That means here subtraction we have to change to addition. How to change that one? We'll see here. First we'll take difference of one positive and other also positive number. Difference of positive integer and positive integer. Next, difference of positive integer is 24 and positive other positive integer is 8. Difference of 24 and 8. Difference of 24 and 8 will write here 24 minus 8. Now, what I said, when you are subtracting the two integers, we have to change the subtraction to the addition. Here, we have to change this minus symbol, the 24 minus 8. First number 24 as it is, you have to write. And the minus has to change to plus, and the plus 8 has to become the minus. After that, the signs will change. The minus will become plus, and the plus 8 will become minus 8. That means I converted here the subtraction to addition. Now we got the addition of the one positive and one negative number. That is 24 plus minus 8. One positive and negative means you have to subtract the numbers. 24 minus 8 is 16. That the biggest number has the plus sign. You have to get the plus 16. Okay, next we'll go to the difference of positive integer and a negative integer. Difference of the positive, we'll take the example here. Difference of 24 and minus 8. Difference of 24 and minus 8 means 24 minus of minus 8. 24 you are subtracting minus 8. 24 minus of minus 8. Means first you have to convert the subtraction to the addition. How you have to convert it? That is 24 as it is, you have to write first. The minus will become plus and minus 8 will become again plus 8. Okay, the minus becomes plus here and the minus 8 will become plus 8. Now we got here addition of the two positive integers 24 plus 8. Means you have to add the two numbers 32, and both the numbers are the positive, it is plus 32. Next we'll go to the difference of a negative integer and a negative integer. Take the example difference of minus 24 and minus 8. Minus 24 minus of minus 8. Now we have to convert the subtraction to addition. First minus 24 as it is here, right? The minus, next we have the minus will become plus, and the minus will become the plus 8 here. Again we changed the subtraction to the addition. Next we have to add the two integers. Here we have got the addition of the one negative integer and one positive integer. We are getting the two different assignments. We have to subtract the numbers here. That is 24 minus 8, it is 16. The biggest number has the minus sign, that we have to write the minus 16. Okay. Next we will see the subtraction of the negative integer with the positive integer. Negative integer with positive integer, we will take example again here. Difference of minus 24 and 8. This we can write as minus 24 minus 8, which is equal to, now I convert to the subtraction to addition, that is equal to minus 24 as it is you are writing. The minus you have to write as a plus, and the plus 8 you have to write as the minus 8. That means we change the difference or subtraction to the addition. Now we got the here the addition of the two negative integers. When you are adding the two negative integers, first you have to add the numbers 24 plus 8, 32, and both the numbers have the negative sign, you have to give the minus, that is minus 32. Okay. Now we have see the two fundamental operations. One is addition, next is subtraction. Next we'll go to the multiplication of integers. This is the third fundamental operation. The multiplication here, first we'll see product. Product means nothing but multiplication. Product of two positive integers. That is positive integer. Two positive integers, positive integer into positive integer, will get positive integer only. How? We'll see the example here. Product of 6 and 5, that is 6 is the positive number, 5 is the positive number. Product means 6 into 5, which is equal to 30. That means when you are multiplying the two positive integers, first of all you have to multiply the numbers, 6 into 5, it is 30. Both the numbers has positive sign, that is plus into plus, we'll write it as plus only, that is 30. That is multiplication of the or product of the two positive integers will get positive integers. Next we have the product of two negative integers, also will get a positive integer only. Example here, product of minus 6 and minus 5, that is minus 6 into minus 5, it is 30. When you are multiplying the two negative integers, first you multiply the numbers, 6, 5 are 30, and minus into minus, you will get a plus only. That is product of two negative integers is also a positive integer. Product of two positive integers or the product of two negative integers is nothing but a positive integer only. Next we'll go to the product of positive integer and negative integer. Here the positive into negative or negative into positive, you will get negative integer only. Product of 6 and minus 5, that is 6 into minus 5. First you multiply the number, 6 into 5 30, and plus into minus is a minus, that is 6 into 5 minus 5 is equal to minus 30. That is product of one positive and one negative integer will get a negative integer. Similarly, product of negative integer and a positive integer also a negative integer. That is the product of minus 6 and 5. That is minus 6 into 5 is equal to minus 30. 6 into 5 30, minus into plus is minus. That is, if you multiply plus into minus is equal to minus only, and minus into plus is also minus only. Next we'll see the, that means here product of two negative or two positive integers is a positive integer, we learnt here. And the product of positive integer and negative integer, or negative integer and positive integer, is a negative integer. Already we discussed it. Next we will go to the division of integers. Division of integers is just like the multiplication only. In the multiplication we are multiplying the two numbers. In the division just we will divide the numbers. Remaining it is similar to the multiplication only. That is, see the here, if you see the example, you can understand here. Division is just like a multiplication only. How it is, quotient of division means nothing but you can read it as quotient also. Quotient of two positive integers is a positive integer. Multiplication of two positive integers is a positive integer. Quotient of two positive integers is a positive integer. That is, when I take the example, quotient of 30 and 5. 30 divided by 5, what will get? 6. Plus 30 divided by plus 5, this plus into plus, plus only, that plus divided by plus also, plus only. Here that is 30 divided by 5 is 6. Next you see the quotient of the two negative integers. The product of the two negative integers is a negative positive integer, and the quotient of the two negative integers is also a positive integer only. That is, minus 30 divided by minus 5, 30 divided by 5 is 6, and minus divided by minus is again plus. Next you will see the quotient of negative integer and a positive integer, or a positive integer and a negative integer will get a negative. In the multiplication also, you have seen that product of negative into positive and the product of positive into negative will get a negative integer. Here also quotient of negative and positive and or positive into negative also will get a negative integer only. That is, see the example here. Minus 30 divided by 5. 30 divided by 5 is 6. Minus divided by plus minus. That is, next to 30 divided by minus 5. 30 divided by 5 is 6. Plus divided by minus 5, minus 6. Here also, we are getting same. And this is the end of the today's online class. Next, in the next class, we'll learn about the rational numbers, representation of rational numbers on number line, representation of rational number, that is P by Q form, to decimal representation, and the decimal representation to P by Q form, and fundamental operations of the rational numbers, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of the rational numbers. Okay, we will learn about this on the online class 2. Okay, thank you one and all.